Good morning, friends, and my dear children. Once again, Yalalitha ma'am is back with another topic, that is benzoid and non-benzoid compounds. Okay, this is one of the topics which is there in the classification of aromatic compounds. Okay, this comes under the chapter of nomenclature of organic compounds. Okay, this is going to be the video number 7. Okay, from nomenclature of organic compounds. So let us go into the topic. So today's topic is benzoid and non-benzoid compounds. Benzoid and non-benzoid compounds. Okay, so what are benzoid and non-benzoid compounds? If I write to the top, you people cannot able to see, I hope. Okay, sorry for the disturbance. Benzoid and non-benzoid compounds. Benzoid and non-benzoid compounds. So what are benzoid and non-benzoid compounds? We are going to learn about that in this video. Okay, so benzoid structures. You all know that all the aromatic compounds are having the main parent for all the aromatic structures is benzene ring. You all know that. Okay, so benzene ring. Benzoid compounds are those which are having benzene ring. And you already have learnt about aromatic compounds are having 4n plus 2 pi electrons. They have planar structure, cyclic structure, and conjugation is observed in them. And they also have, according to Huckel's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. You have learnt this. So benzoid compounds. So what are those benzoid compounds? Means compounds with the benzene ring. Okay, now compounds with the benzene ring, right? Compounds with benzene ring, okay, which follows the aromaticity. Okay, all the compounds which are having benzene and the derivatives of benzene, all those comes under the category of benzoid compounds. Okay, so let us learn examples for benzoid compounds. What are the different examples? Okay, so all types of benzene rings with their derivatives also comes under the category of what? Benzoid compounds. So let us learn some examples. Okay, so first one, you all know benzene is an aromatic structure with alternate double bonds in it. Okay, here also you are finding planar structure, conjugation is there, okay, cyclic structure, and 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, here totally 6 pi electrons are there. So it is a benzene structure, you all know that. So same like that, if two fused rings are joined together, okay, same like benzene, if two benzene rings, fused rings are there, okay, now if two fused rings joined together, okay, you call it as what? Naphthalene. Okay, now if two benzene rings, fused rings, okay, which has alternate double bonds are there, right? Which has alternate double bonds. This is an example for what? Benzoid structure. Here, this structure, you call it as what? Naphthalene. Okay, now it is also comes under benzoid compounds, because benzene rings, two benzene rings being fused together, okay, they are present like this, right? We keep seeing the different examples, right? So next thing is third example, anthracene with three fused rings. You all know anthracene. Okay, if three fused rings are there just end to end with each other, then you call them as what? You call the structure as anthracene. Okay, this also having benzene rings, okay, fused together, okay, with alternate double bonds. Okay, so such kind of structures, you call them as what? With alternate double bonds. You have to check like that. Okay, here double bond is there. So we keep double bond here and alternately we leave one and we keep one more. Okay. So here one, here one, here one. So same like that for this also. Here double bond is there. Okay, now here not there. So you can keep here. You can leave this and you can keep here. Okay, and here alternates double bonds. Okay, so like that you have three fused rings. If they are there, you call it as what? Anthracene. Anthracene. This is also a benzoid structure. Okay, here how many pi electrons are there? 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Means in place of n, you are going to keep 3. 2 rings here. 4n plus 2. In place of n, if you keep here 2. 4 2s are 8 plus 2. 10 pi electrons are there. Yes, you are finding 5. Okay, now you are finding 4n plus 2. In place of n, you are going to keep what? 2. Okay, now you are going to keep 2 in place of n. Okay, so you will be finding 5. Okay, somewhere we have drawn extra things, I think so. Okay, suppose if you draw these double bonds, let us check with the double bonds. You have to check with the formation of double bonds also. Suppose if you keep a common double bond like this, you will leave one and you will keep here one, okay, here you will leave, here one, then here one you will keep. So this will be your 4n plus 2 pi electrons, 5 pi bonds you are finding, so 10 pi electrons are there, right? So it comes under aromatic structure, right? Here also, here if you keep n value 3, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now if you keep n value 3, 4 into 3 plus 2, 12 plus 2 means 14 pi electrons should be there. Okay, now 14 pi electrons. Okay, so you have to keep double bonds alternatively. So you have to check that. Okay, alternate double bonds. Okay, you have to check like that. So we kept 3 double bonds here alternatively. Conjugation is maintained. Okay, so we'll leave. Here already double bond is there. Either this side if you draw or this side if you draw, it makes no difference. So here one, okay, and you will leave here and you are going to draw one here, right? And next, here double bond not there, right? So you can draw double bond here, okay? So this structure, you can call it as what? Anthracene. And here also you are finding 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now even though these all comes under the category of benzoid structures, they all are what? Aromatic. Aromatic means 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now so anthracene structure, 4 into 3 plus 2, 14 pi electrons are there. Okay, so this is third example for what? Benzoid structures, right? Now take down fourth example. Example 4. Okay, phenanthrene. You can take the example of phenanthrene. Okay, means one of the cyclic rings has been drawn, okay, like this. This structure, okay, fused rings. These all three are what? Fused rings. Okay, you are going to keep alternate double bonds. Okay, now alternately double bonds. Okay, so here already double bond is there, so you are not supposed to keep here, so we'll keep here. Okay, leave this and keep double bond here. Now coming to this ring, okay, already double bond is here, so you have to leave one and you have to draw. So let us leave this and let us draw a double bond here. So leave this and the next double bond will be here, so that conjugation is maintained. Isn't it or not? Conjugation is maintained. Okay, so this structure, you call it as what? Phenanthrene. This structure is called as phenanthrene. Phenanthrene. Okay, here also alternate double bonds is there, planar structure is there, cyclic structure, Huckel's rule according to this. 4n plus 2 pi electrons. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 pi bonds are there. So 14 pi electrons. Okay. this structure, you call it as what? Phenanthrene. 4n plus 2 pi electrons, in place of n you are going to keep 3. So 12 plus 2, 14 pi electrons. So this also comes under benzoid structure, right? So next we are going to learn about the fifth example. Please note down. I request every child to please make a note of what all your teacher says. Okay, so next comes chrysine. Okay, now with four benzene rings, fused benzene rings, joined end to end with each other like this. Okay, now four benzene rings. Okay, fused benzene rings, fused rings. Please try to understand carefully. Okay, fused benzene rings. You need to keep alternate double bonds. Okay, so this structure, you call it as what? Chrysine. Chrysine. Okay, now we start keeping double bonds alternatively so that what we call its conjugation is maintained. So first ring has been satisfied with all three double bonds. Now here already this double bond is common for these two rings. So we keep here one double bond and alternately we'll leave one and we'll keep here one double bond. Now this double bond became common for these two rings. Okay, now so leave one and draw a double bond either here or here so that it will be common. If you draw here, it will be common for these two rings. Okay, now you are leaving this and drawing the double bond here. Leave this and draw the double bond here. Now coming to this, already double bond is there, so leave this, so draw a double bond here. Okay, alternately it should be there, so leave this, draw a double bond here. So this is your chrysine structure. Okay, this is your chrysine structure. Here also 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now 4 into 3 plus 2 means here in place of n you are going to keep 4. I'm very sorry, because 4 rings you are finding. So 4 4s are 16 plus 2 means 18 pi electrons you should find. 18 pi electrons. Okay, now so here you can find 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 pi bonds you are finding, isn't it or not? If you find 9 pi electrons, I mean 9 pi bonds, you will be finding 18 pi electrons. Okay, now here better I write down 18 pi electrons. Okay, now 18 pi electrons. Okay, so these all are what? This kind of structures, you call them as what? Benzoid structures. You can even take the example of biphenyl also. Okay, now you can take the example of biphenyl. Okay, now sixth example, biphenyl structure. Biphenyl structure. So biphenyl structure, you all know, it is having two rings but not fused rings. Okay, now joined end to end with a single bond. Biphenyl structure. Okay, now so you are drawing alternate double bonds. Okay, alternate double bonds. So this biphenyl structure. Okay, now 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, this becomes benzoid structure, but fused, these are not fused rings. Okay, now so this all comes under the category of what? Benzoid structures. Now we are going to learn about non-benzoid structures. Okay, I'm just rubbing the board. Please take a note of this. Right. Yes. Next, we have to keep side heading non-benzoid structures. So what are the examples for non-benzoid structures? Okay, please keep side heading non-benzoid structures. Yes, non-benzoid structures. Non-benzoid structures. Okay, so what are non-benzoid structures? Right, the structures in which no benzene ring is available. Okay, now benzene ring is not there, but aromaticity is maintained. Okay, now the ring structures may not be like benzene ring. Okay, now that means these are not the derivatives of benzene, or these are not here the parent chain is not the benzene ring. Okay, so that's why they are called as what? Non-benzoid structures. So let us learn examples for non-benzoid structures. They follow aromaticity. Please understand carefully. They follow aromaticity. That means they have the structures like planar structure, okay, cyclic structure. According to Huckel's rule, 4n plus 2 pi electrons, okay, conjugation. All these are maintained. But the only thing is they don't have benzene ring. Such kind of structures are called as what? Non-benzoid structures. Okay, so let us learn examples. Examples for non-benzoid structures. So what are the examples? Okay, already we have learnt these examples in heterocyclic compounds. Okay, so first one is pyrrole. You all have already learnt this in heterocyclic compounds. Okay, now in heterocyclic compounds you have seen that there are elements other than carbon. So here other than carbon, one nitrogen is there, okay, with alternate double bonds. Okay, so here the ring is cyclic, okay, and it is following conjugation pi bond sigma bond lone pair, pi bond sigma bond lone pair. Okay, it is following conjugation, it is observing planar structure, all those things are there, but still they does not contains what? Benzene ring. That's why these are called as non-benzoid structures. Okay, so what is the name of this compound? Pyrrole. Pyrrole. Okay, everything is there but non-benzoid. Okay, conjugation is maintained, cyclic structure is there. Okay, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Here 4 pi electrons are there in place of n. 4n plus 2 if you keep in place of n, you will keep 1. 4 into 1 plus 2 means 4 plus 2, 6 pi electrons. Here already 2 pi bonded electrons and 1 pair of electron participating in conjugation. Okay, now 1 pair of electrons are there which are participating in conjugation. That's why those are also to be considered. So 6 pi electrons are there. 6 pi electrons, but no benzene ring. That's why non-benzoid. Okay, take down the second example. Second example is furan. Okay, furan. Furan structure. Okay, second example is furan structure with the same alternate, I mean conjugation is there, pi sigma lone pair. One lone pair only here you have to consider because the other lone pair does not participate in conjugation. Okay, how you can able to understand that whether it is participating in conjugation or not? Okay, that you will be learning shortly, right? Pi bond sigma bond lone pair, pi bond sigma bond lone pair. One lone pair you will see it to be participating in conjugation. So it has cyclic structure, planar structure, and conjugation is followed, and 4n plus 2 pi electrons, all these are followed. So it is aromatic but not having benzene ring. That's why it is non-benzoid. Okay, now so it is what? It is having 6 pi electrons. 6 pi electrons are there. Okay, so 6 pi electrons, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now please remember 4n plus 2 pi electrons, 6 pi electrons, n is equal to 1. So 4 into 1 plus 2, 6 pi electrons, right? Next, we go for the third example. Third example is thiophene. In place of oxygen, you are going to keep sulfur. The same kind of structure you will be getting. Sulfur. Okay, now, if you keep sulfur, you call it as what? Thiophene. Thiophene. It is also having non-benzoid structure, aromatic but non-benzoid, thiophene. Okay, now 4n plus 2 pi electrons, 4n plus 2 pi electrons means 6 pi electrons are there. 6 pi electrons are there. That's why it also comes under the category of what? Non-benzoid but aromatic, right? We'll take some more examples. Yes, please note down because I'm rubbing the board. Drawing one after the other and rubbing the board. Okay, and you will come across pyridine, which we already have learned, pyridine. Okay, now pyridine, right? The structure of pyridine. Okay, now nitrogen with a lone pair of electrons, and this is the structure of what? Pyridine. Pyridine. Here also 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Okay, now conjugation is maintained, 4n plus 2 pi electrons. So non-benzoid structure. Non-benzoid structure. Aromatic, right? So next, fifth example, we have to learn certain ions. Okay, now okay, other than ions you have two more examples, right? Other than ions, two more examples. Better I draw that first, and then we go for certain types of ions, which are like they are having ions, ion form. Okay, so this is what oxygen is there, and double bonds alternately. This you call it as tropine. Okay, now tropine, tropone, actually tropone. Okay, non-benzoid structure, non-benzoid, but what we call aromatic, but non-benzoid, right? Tropone. And next, tropoline, another example. If OH is being connected to here, then you will get tropoline. Okay, example six. Okay, here this double bond is not visible, I think. Is it not visible? Better I draw a little bit side. I'm drawing here, you can check. Here OH is attached, and here as usual double bond O is there. For tropone, if OH is attached, you will call it as what? Tropoline. Okay, now tropoline. This is also an example for what? Non-benzoid. Tropoline. Tropoline, sixth one. And you can take another example also. Example number 7. Okay, here we are going to take certain ions. Cyclopropenyl cation. This also we have learnt in heterocyclic structures. Cyclopropylium ion. Cation. Cyclopropenium cation. Okay, now cyclopropenium cation. Cyclopropylium cation. Okay, cyclopropylium cation, that is also an example for what? Non-benzoid structure. And if I draw here, you can able to see. Okay, you have one more structure like this, cyclopentadienyl anion. Okay, cyclopentadienyl anion. Cyclopentadienyl anion. Cyclopentadienyl anion. So this is an example for what? cyclopentadienyl anion, which comes under what? Non-benzoid structure. Okay, now non-benzoid structure. And you have one more example. I'll just draw here. I think you can able to see one more structure. Okay, one more structure. That is tropolium cation. Tropolium cation. Okay, tropolium cation. Tropolium cation. So all this comes under non-benzoid structures. Okay, even though they are aromatic, all of them follow aromaticity, but still they follow what? Non-benzoid structures. This doesn't have benzene ring with them. So benzene ring here, it won't act as a parent chain. Okay, so this is all about the differences. I mean, different types of examples which we have learned for what? Benzoid and non-benzoid structures. Okay, so please keep writing and practice. Okay, until then, okay, please keep watching my videos so that you can have a better understanding of concepts. Okay, I would like to say one more thing. Please, those who are visiting my channel for the first time, please subscribe to my channel. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye.